favorite teacher is like choosing between your parents. Impossible. I think each teacher has their own special quality which makes them a beautiful and special person to me. And each and every person who taught me something in my life are a teacher to me. It could be my friends, parents, or my teachers at school. They're very special, and I think they possess their own good qualities, which I appreciate them and like them for. 5th September is a remarkable day when I can express my gratitude to my teachers. First of all, I'm very sorry to all my teachers if I disappointed them in any way. Thank you so much for sharing your valuable knowledge, and I hope you all have a great future ahead. A very, very happy Teachers' Day to everybody. Thank you.
The good qualities I think a teacher should have is they should have their own unique way of teaching the students so that they don't get bored in the classrooms. I'm glad to say that all the teachers in Rainbow School are very humble, knowledgeable, and have their own unique way of teaching. So a very happy Teachers' Day to all my teachers.
I would like to extend my warm wishes to all the teachers on the auspicious occasion of Teachers' Day. Teachers are the salt to the earth and light to our life. So I wish all the teachers a happy Teachers' Day, and by bowing my head, by giving respect and tributes to all my teachers. Thank you.
Firstly, a happy Teachers' Day to all of the teachers. Usually, people look for in a teacher is the new creative ideas what she or he possesses, and the new creative ways how she teaches her part to the students. And what I look for in a teacher is the same thing, yeah, the creative things and the creative ideas she has or he has, and the patience and the tolerance she has to teach her student.
Happy Teachers' Day.
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 If you have a teacher with value who can teach you how to behave in society and all, you're the luckiest person in the entire planet. More than studies or whatever it might be, we need to learn discipline and values. So we are so proud that we have a director, a correspondent, principal, and all the teachers in our school are teaching us important values that we can use in the society and be proud of it. So 5th September, we would like to show our gratitude to all our teachers. Thank you so much for everything you have done, for scolding us, for appreciating us, for always, you know, supporting us. Whatever it might be, you are supporting us. So thank you so much for not losing faith in us. And I hope you all have a great time. A very happy Teachers' Day.
Radhakrishnan was born in 1888 in Tiruthani, a temple town of Madras Presidency, now in Tamil Nadu. He was brought up in an environment of Hindu rituals, Vedic knowledge and Oriental traditions. He also had an exposure to Christianity as he studied in missionary educational institutions. The multicultural and multi-religious exposure had a strong bearing on his life and philosophy. Krishnan wrote scores of books. He rarely wrote about himself. Therefore, very little is known about his childhood. As a teacher, Dr. Radhakrishnan was very popular. His students looked upon him as a philosopher and guide.
It is necessary that each one of us should think that the purpose of education is not merely physical fitness or mental alertness. It is the growth in spiritual sensitivity. Unless we develop that kind of spiritual sensitivity, we cannot be regarded as properly educated.
In 1921, when he left Mysore University for joining Kolkata University, his students came up with a rare gesture. They took him all the way from the university campus to the railway station in a flower-decked carriage pulled by the students themselves. They still remember him with nostalgia.
Radhakrishnan believed that the right education could solve many ills of the society. He wanted to improve the quality of education and build up a strong relationship between the teacher and the student.
Children must be taught the history of the different nations where they will perceive their uniqueness. They must be taught, even when they are young, the elements of modern science and technology. They must be given glimpses into world literature so that their own minds are sharpened and feelings refined. It is my earnest desire that our children are treated as human beings and not as automata.